State University Alumni Association and graduate of the class of 1975 to come to the podium and officially induct our graduates into the Alumni Association of Bridgewater State University. Dr. Vieira.
To be a witness to this induction, I call upon all alumni of Bridgewater State University who are present to please stand up.
That's you.
He stole my line. President Clark, upon your recommendation, I am pleased to induct into membership in the Alumni Association the graduates of the class of 2017 at Bridgewater State University. Fellow alumni, I welcome you into the association with all of us who have preceded you and ask that you share a continued interest in the welfare and excellence of Bridgewater State University. I offer each of you my warm congratulations and best wishes. You can please be seated.
Thank you, Dr. Vieira. Sorry, I have to make you please rise one more time. I would now like to invite Father Bill Devine to the podium to offer the benediction.
Let's thank God for a lot of answered prayers. Let's bow our heads and pray. Lord, while this graduation ceremony comes to an end, it marks a new beginning for these graduates. I ask you, Lord, to bless these graduates not only with faith that enables them to believe in you, but the humility to always ask your help. Bless them with the desire to live up to the motto of this university, to minister unto others. Bless those who are still uncertain about their careers. Give them patience and the direction they need. Bless these graduates with success in finding jobs that will enable them to help them pay off their student loans. And as they celebrate their graduation with their family and friends tonight and the days ahead, bless them with good judgment and keep them safe. Amen.
Thank you, Father Devine. At this time, I ask Ms. Maloney to come forward and lead us in singing the first verse of the Alma Mater. The words are on the back of the program. Thank you, Ms. Maloney. Please be seated. Thank you for celebrating the accomplishments of our graduates. You may rejoin our graduates at the reception in the campus center courtyard immediately following the ceremony. Please remain in your seats until the reception has filed out of the tent. We appreciate your cooperation in exiting the tent after the recessional so that we may prepare for our afternoon commencement. Congratulations, class of 2017.
Thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Board of Trustees, administrators, faculty, librarians, staff, and students of Bridgewater State University, I proclaim this undergraduate commencement convocation convened. You may be seated. Thanks to Touch of Brass for providing the music at today's ceremony, our faculty marshals, Dr. Carol Petrosino and Dr. John Marvell, and our student marshals, Ms. Clara Gonsalves and Mr. Cameron Ramos. Out of respect for today's graduates, I ask you that please silence all electronic devices for the duration of today's ceremony. Please stand if you are able, and welcome to the podium Ms. Angela Maloney, who will lead us in singing the first verse of America the Beautiful. The words are on the back of the program. Thank you, Ms. Maloney. You may be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, we at the university are proud of our president. I'm pleased to introduce the 12th president of Bridgewater State University, Frederick Clark, a graduate of 1983. In addition to his degree in political science from Bridgewater, President Clark holds a Juris Doctorate degree from Suffolk University. He served for many years as the district director for the late Congressman Joe Moakley. During that period, President Clark maintained close ties to his alma mater, serving terms as a member and later chairman of the university's Board of Trustees. In addition, President Clark served as chairman of the Massachusetts Board of Higher Education and as executive officer of the Massachusetts State University System. In 2010, he had a pivotal role in gaining legislative support for the granting of university status to Bridgewater and its sister state colleges. In November 2014, the Board of Trustees selected him to succeed Dr. Dana Mola Faria, and he began his presidency on July 1st, 2015. Please join me in welcoming President Frederick Clark.
Thank you very much, Dr. Sharma. Hello, my friends. It's so great to see you. Thank you all for coming together to help us to celebrate a truly amazing and wonderful class of 2017. I want to just take a minute at the very beginning of this commencement to thank and recognize all of the volunteers, all of the folks on campus that helped to put today together. They've given so selflessly of their talent, their time throughout the year in preparation for this very special day. Thank you, Bridgewater State, for putting your best foot forward for our amazing graduates. At this time, I want to acknowledge a few special guests of the university. First, the members of our Board of Trustees, and I would ask them to stand and remain standing. The chair of our board, Mr. Eugene Durgan. Dr. Sue Sakowicz, the secretary of the board and BSU class of 1975. Mr. Kyle Bueno, student trustee. I want to be as popular as Kyle Bueno when I grow up. Mr. David Alexander. Mr. Scott Longo, also Bridgewater class of 1989. Mr. Edward Ned Murphy, Mr. Mark Oliari, Ms. Angela Pimentel, BSU class of 2000. And also a few other special guests on the stage. We have Dr. Jack Spraga, the president of Bristol Community College and your keynote speaker. Another good friend, I call him Mr. Bridgewater actually, and that's Mr. Lou Ricciardi, BSU class of 1981, devoted supporter, former trustee, former chair of our board, and for whom the College of Business is named. Also, Mr. Nate McKinnon, Assistant Commissioner, Chief of Staff, Massachusetts Board of Higher Education. And I do want to interject, because we had great news last night. One of our students was elected to the Board of Higher Education, the first Bridgewater student ever to be elected to the Board of Higher Education, Danielle Dupuy. Also seated in the audience, our great state senator, Mark Pacheco. Thank you, Senator, for coming. And Mrs. Joanne Spraga. Please join me in a round of applause for our special guests. You can be seated. Okay. It's now my privilege to introduce the distinguished members of the campus community. At this time, I would like to ask the faculty and librarians, our amazing faculty and librarians, to please stand and remain standing for a moment, please. How about your faculty and librarians? I'd also ask that all the professional staff, clerical staff that are on the stage, please stand. I'd like to ask the deans, members of the provost council, directors, to please rise and remain standing as well. I want to ask the university's provost and our vice presidents to please rise and remain standing as well. So to the parents, families, friends of our graduating students, I ask that you take special note of all of those who are standing behind me. During their time at Bridgewater State University, our students have benefited from exceptional role models who guided and shaped our candidates into the amazing folks that they are today. People behind me have invested personally in the noble causes of teaching, advising, supporting, counseling, and mentoring. And today, they're all here to express their pride in the candidates' accomplishments and to offer their true and sincerest congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, members of today's graduating class, please join me in a warm round of applause for Bridgewater's finest. It's now my great pleasure to invite to the podium Mr. Eugene Durgan, the chair of our Board of Trustees at BSU. Mr. Durgan has enjoyed a long career of leadership and has generously given his time to our institution as a volunteer for over 25 years, serving on BSU's governing board as trustee and chairman, in addition to serving as chair of the BSU Foundation Board. Ladies and gentlemen, the hardest working trustee in the Commonwealth, Gene Durgan.
Thank you, President Clark. Well, I can see it in your eyes. I can see it by the smile in their faces. The sleepless nights are over. That feeling, will this day ever happen? That feeling, oh my God, will this day ever happen, is over. Your day has come. Of course, I'm talking to the parents and families of our graduates. I'm very privileged to extend to you the heartiest congratulations of the Board of Trustees. For several years now, we have been hearing of the achievements of the class of 2017, of its camaraderie, of the values that you have brought to your soon-to-be alma mater, and the legacy that you are leaving. We finally get a chance to see you gathered as a group, and we are extremely proud of you. Several years ago, you gathered for the first time as essentially a group of strangers with a shared goal of a Bridgewater degree. First as strangers, and now, and for the rest of your lives, you will introduce somebody sitting close to you this morning as one of your best friends in life. You also came a bit curious and perhaps daunted by the studies that were ahead of you. Now, and for the rest of your lives, you will refer to a Bridgewater faculty member by name, and perhaps one who is seated behind me this morning, as one of the best teachers and mentors you've ever had in life. Over the course of many years, I've had the chance to meet literally thousands of Bridgewater graduates. And I can tell you, when you've met one Bridgewater graduate, you've met one Bridgewater graduate. With many unique talents and values, Bridgewater alums have made extraordinary contributions to their families, their region, their state, and well beyond. You will do the same. You will soon learn of the deep and unbendable bond that exists between an alum and Bridgewater. And that bond will be as strong 50 years from now as it is today. You will gather many times over the years as a reunion group and proudly remember the class of 2017. We wish you great success and happiness. But when those occasional lousy days happen, come back to Bridgewater. Come back by car, by plane, by train, or maybe just in a daydream. I guarantee you will be refreshed and reinvigorated. As a famous basketball coach used to tell his players, you can have many good days, but you can't have a perfect day unless you've done something to help someone. May you have many good days and many perfect days. Finally, so that we may have proper decorum at this auspicious celebration, we ask our families and friends, when your graduate comes across the stage to accept the degree that they worked so hard for, that you yell your bloody heads off. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. To bring greetings on behalf of the university's faculty and librarians, I am pleased to invite to the podium Dr. Maria Hegblum, president of the Massachusetts State University Association Bridgewater chapter and a member of our communications department. Dr. Hegblum.
Good morning, graduates. Today is a day for celebration and reflection. It is a chance to acknowledge your hard work as well as the challenges and obstacles that you have faced to reach this important goal. Which is why I want to talk to you today about Star Wars, of course. This is a movie about a young hero, if you haven't seen it, who, against all odds, found the strength deep inside himself to develop his talents, ultimately defeating Darth Vader and the entire evil galactic empire, saving the entire universe. Who isn't a sucker for the underdog? But Luke Skywalker didn't do it alone. If Han hadn't come out of nowhere at the last minute, Luke wouldn't have stood a chance against the Death Star. If Leia hadn't blasted their way out of the prison block, where would they all be? Back on the Death Star, that's where. Our lives may not be movies, but in a similar way, in the real world, the underdog, as well as the overachiever, rarely stands alone. We face our challenges and overcome our obstacles with the help of many. If you are sitting here today, you probably had your share of obstacles to overcome on your path to graduation. Certainly, your hard work and perseverance played no small role, but so did the help of others. Friends and family lent strength and support. Extra jobs helped you overcome financial barriers. Community colleges started many of you on your educational path. And throughout, your professors at BSU guided you along that path. For every Luke, there is an Obi-Wan. As your faculty, our obligation was to you first and foremost, to planning excellent classes, to providing thoughtful advising and mentorship, to helping you choose your path and guiding you along it, a path that includes getting to this very day. Your faculty at BSU are so proud of you today. We are proud of our work together, proud of the curiosity, questions, excitement, and engagement you brought into our classrooms, and excited for where you will go next. Some of you may even destroy a Death Star, bring down an evil galactic empire, or save the universe. And just as you have been supported in your educational journey, we, the faculty, have been supported by our union, the Massachusetts State College Association. Our union might not quite be the rebellion, but it helps ensure that our valuable work with students is supported. It gives faculty a voice in strengthening the mission of the university. It helps protect resources for developing engaging curricula and time for meaningful interaction with students. Our contract helps to make our commitment to students possible. Today, the results of that commitment are on beautiful display here in all of you. All of us have gotten here together. As a member of the faculty at BSU and as the president of our faculty union, I share with you, on behalf of all the faculty, the words of the late Jean Stonehouse, dedicated faculty member, union president, Jedi. We wish you all the good things of life, love in your homes, friendships, meaningful work, lives well lived. Congratulations, class of 2017.
Thank you very much, Dr. Hegblum. It's our tradition at Bridgewater State that the president offers a few parting words. But graduates, before another minute goes by, let me just tell you how proud all of us are of you. How proud of the effort, the determination that it took to bring each of you in your own way to this very moment. Commencement addresses are supposed to be filled with inspiration and words of wisdom to a graduating class. But in truth, you are the inspiration here today. No clever turn of a phrase could ever be more inspiring than the story of any one of you. Your story is the story of Bridgewater State University. And I want to make sure that you feel the weight, the import of what you've accomplished. You may not always see it, but we do. Consider the stories of your fellow graduates. Tina Brown had a plan to go to veterinary school, but life intervened, and she ended up working as a tax assistant, an administrative assistant, and as a personal assistant, among other things. But over time, Tina realized that the person she needed to assist the most was herself. So she enrolled at Bristol Community College and then went on to BSU. She figured out that she could end up with a bachelor's instead of an associate's degree for only $10,000 more. That's a business major for you. Get the bang for your buck. But in order to graduate today with a degree in management she paid for on her own, Tina took an astounding 9 classes in her last semester here at Bridgewater. She will graduate today with a 3.9 GPA. Tina's story is of someone who worked hard to achieve the important goal of a college education. Nobody gave it to her. She earned it, credit by credit. For Kelly McCarthy, managing athletics, academics, a job, and life at home was no easy task. And she struggled to figure out a good balance. Not wanting to give up something she loved, but knowing she had to, Kelly gave up her last year of softball so that she could graduate in 4 years with honors and a double major in English and elementary education. All of you here today who can claim a double major with elementary education knows what it takes. You've successfully passed not one, not two, but five state teacher tests. You finished one whole major before you started the other. You even survived the block. If you like kids, go babysit. But if you want to be an elementary educator, you've got to be made of tougher stuff. And when Kelly stood in front of a class of 25 9-year-olds this past spring, she knew that she was. Here's another story. Before coming to Bridgewater, commuter student DJ Riley spent 4 years in the Marines. 4 years in the Marines. The day he returned home in late August 2014, having just been honorably discharged, he landed at Logan, he showered at his mother's house, and then he drove immediately to Bridgewater for orientation. Commuting made it difficult to connect with the campus, but with the help of our Veteran Center, DJ navigated the tricky process of having his military service transfer here to Bridgewater, and he settled in. Commuting can be tricky. I know, parking. I know. But it's not too hard for a Marine who was deployed to Afghanistan and earned a Purple Heart. One more story. Nina Herrera. She excelled in her studies at the same time she worked at a campus job as a student security officer and a part-time job back home in Fall River. Worry about how she could pay for school was always with her, but she was committed, as were her parents, who worked a lot of overtime to help Nina become the first person in her family to graduate from college. That might just be the best Mother's Day present that she could give to her mom who worked all that overtime. Congratulations, Mom. Congratulations, all mothers, in advance of Mother's Day tomorrow. Nina graduates today with her degree in geography, and she'll use the Dr. Madhu Ra scholarship she earned this year to pursue a master's degree at Johns Hopkins University. Although no two stories are alike on this campus, I bet you hear the stories of some of your peers. In those stories, you hear a version of your own story. A story of arranging a work schedule, a school schedule, and a seemingly impossible balance. A story of sacrifice, one bill this month, that bill the next month. It's a story of risk. The first in your family to attend college, perhaps to even come to the United States, or the decision to return to school after so many years away. It's a story of love, caring for siblings or babies or parents and still showing up to class the very next day. It's a story of hard work, long hours, and so many responsibilities. But it's also a story of success, an award won, a trip taken, research completed, a degree earned. All of it more precious for the effort that it took for you to get here. I stand here today as a Bridgewater graduate myself, and I am so proud to join your story to mine, and to the story of this special place, the story of all of us here at BSU. Your time at Bridgewater might be over in a couple of minutes, in a sense, but remember that we come with you wherever you go. This institution, the people you met, the honors you've amassed, the risks you've taken, maybe the missteps you've survived, all of it is a part of you, and I can't wait to see what comes next for each of you. Many of you will commit to your state, to your communities. You'll bring the same energy and grit that you brought here at Bridgewater, and you'll apply them to solving problems, righting wrongs wherever you face them. You'll raise families, you'll work hard at jobs, you'll make plans. Sometimes those won't work out. But a Bridgewater student is no fragile flower. And whatever comes at you, I know that you'll leave here with the skills and the talents, the intellect and the heart to meet that challenge. And wherever you land, you will blossom. So do me a favor. Go out into the world and show them what it means to be a Bridgewater graduate. Show them the toughness, the love, the loyalty that defines each one of you. My friends, one more thing. Come back. Please come back and be there for other students, perhaps in a way, for the way this institution was for you. Continue to inspire on this campus the way you'll inspire out in the world. Fellow Bears, I started today by telling you how proud of you I am. Let me end by saying how proud I know I will always be. Congratulations, class of 2017. I'm so honored now to introduce our keynote speaker, our friend, our partner, Dr. Jack Spraga of Bristol Community College. After 17 years of service, he's retiring as the president of BCC in Fall River. He has created opportunities for so many students and invested in their success with the development of a new administrative structure that strengthens services for students by unifying all of the enrollment functions. Dr. Spraga initiated new campus councils to focus on marshaling college resources to better serve students and ensure that each and every student has the necessary resources and support to reach their full potential. BSU and BCC just a couple of days ago signed an historic agreement to expand opportunities to even more students. Throughout his career, Dr. Spraga has maintained a continuous presence in the classroom. He's earned awards for teaching excellence. He's published 5 books and authored several articles in history. He holds a PhD and a Master of Arts in History from Georgetown University, a Bachelor of Arts from Union College. He was a Fulbright Scholar at the London School of Economics and Political Science. Although he's very humble, I want to let you know that Dr. Spraga served heroically as a pilot in the U.S. Air Force during the Vietnam War, flying. He flew 1,848 missions and earned the Distinguished Flying Cross. And I want you to know, he would hate that I told you this, but very often those missions were very dangerous, and he would substitute himself for a married pilot or a pilot with family to protect them against harm. That's the kind of man he is. In honor of the hundreds of our BSU students who transferred here from Bristol Community College, ladies and gentlemen, I am very proud to welcome today's keynote speaker, Dr. Jack Spraga.
Well, thank you, President Clark. That was remarkable. I want to congratulate you. You made it. Congratulations, everyone. Just quickly, would you raise your hand if BCC transfers to, look at that. Yeah, how about any community college transfer? And you know what this signals is the wonderful relationship that President Clark and the Bridgewater State University Administration has arranged for this seamless pathway. And so congratulations to you, and congratulations to all of the graduates. My thanks go out to Trustee Chair Eugene J. Durgan, Jr., to the entire Board of Trustees at Bridgewater, to President Clark, and all the faculty and staff at Bridgewater State University for this wonderful honor. It is truly a humbling experience, and I am most grateful. I shall always cherish this moment. What a kind and generous introduction President Clark provided. Thank you. But I hope it hasn't deducted from my allotted time. Graduates, may I begin by offering my warmest congratulations on your notable success at Bridgewater State University. We are all delighted for you. In addition, I want to acknowledge on your behalf the support of your family, loved ones, and friends, as well as the support of the outstanding Bridgewater faculty and staff. You have provided a wonderful presence on campus. Bridgewater is better because of your presence. Your success means Bridgewater's success. Preparing for this speech, I pored over the standard commencement statements invoked to inspire graduates. These include the road taken or not taken, letting your reach exceed your grasp, and perhaps even stopping by the woods on a snowy evening. But in seeing another of these popularisms, my mind turned a little differently. You have heard, I'm sure, the verse of Henry Wadsworth Longfellow entitled "The Arrow and the Song." I shot an arrow into the air, and it fell to earth I know not where. He also breathed a song into the air, but he didn't know where that went either until a third verse. Recently, I came across a greeting card, and on the front of the card were those introductory words, but inside was the pithy comment, "I lose more arrows." And this really touches on something I want to urge upon you today. Don't be afraid to lose your arrows. Dare to be excellent, but also dare to risk failure. The opposite of success is not failure. It is refusing to try. Recall that old expression, we learn by trial and error. Dare to be different and exceptional. Take a risk. Eschew conformity. Please, for the sake of our society, continue to dare to excel. Don't become overly comfortable. You must grapple with the great issues and eternal verities. Please persist in fighting those two evil twins, conformity and mediocrity. This is not an easy task, for as Matthew Prior warned us over three centuries ago, from ignorance our comfort flows. The only wretched are the wise. Also, bear in mind that mediocrity is its own reward. One of the greatest needs of our day is a force, a weapon, to fight mediocrity, one that will teach us how to promote the creative forces within us. Along these same lines, you know about the seven deadly sins, and in particular, I want to focus on one of them, envy. In particular, and in my opinion, envy lies at the root of many social and cultural controversies that plague our nation. It has not been fashionable in certain quarters to praise excellence and to advocate high standards. Fortunately, that's not the case at Bridgewater State University. But success and excellence frequently spawn envy. The less successful and envious tear down standards. These underachievers dismiss and even attack conventional formats that they cannot adhere to. Nowadays, to focus on successful people is to invite ridicule as triumphalism. Any form of striving that once made people heroes is now dismissed. Consider, for example, the pejorative terms in current usage that are routinely applied to people who have committed themselves to performing with excellence and acquiring some special expertise. Competition doesn't create character. I maintain competition exposes character. Out of envy, we have created what Philip Reeve has called the triumph of the therapeutic. This therapeutic ethos leads to troubling social trends and a cult of enabling, what I refer to as the politics of excuse. Who takes responsibility nowadays? How often do you find an individual in today's world who stands up and says, "I was at fault," or "the buck stops with me"? Envy infects us with a terrible disease that threatens to reach epidemic proportions and undermine excellence. There is something else to mention, which you already know. Success in your academic and service accomplishments represent outstanding examples, relies heavily on hard work. The truly gifted are rare exceptions. Toil and sweat are the basic ingredients of accomplishment in this life. Our friend Longfellow knew this. He created these lines: "The heights of the great, reached and kept, were not attained by sudden flight, but they, while their companies slept, were toiling upward in the night." Similarly, on the same crucial point, Henry W. Austin observed, "Genius, that power that dazzles mortal eyes, is oft but perseverance in disguise." Your hard work has propelled you to this point, but you have many roads to travel. Hard work must remain in the forefront. People sometimes forget that. There are few shortcuts on the many roads you face. Remember that you can usually find people not far from where they quit. When you give up on yourself, you've committed a crime, and it's a crime that carries with it a life sentence. Some years ago, Oliver Wendell Holmes talked about the process of achievement and academic success as truly springing from the inner self. In sharp contrast to the rationale of envy that I described, Holmes said that success all too frequently emerges when you have worked, quote, when you have worked alone, when you have felt around you a black gulf of solitude, in isolation, in hope, and in despair, but trusting in your own unshakable will, unquote. I would surmise that many of you can identify with what Holmes, in his discerning insight, pointed out. What about all those countless all-nighters? They're all over now, are they? Briefly, I should mention a few other essentials for your toolkits as you depart Bridgewater and slide down the razor blade of life. And these all have to do with your senses: a sense of common good and general welfare, or common weal; a sense of responsibility and a sense of commitment to keep you tilted toward the germane and away from the superficial; a sense of humility and a sense of generosity. We are all trustees of the scholarship of the ages and the great intellectual chain of being. Be contributors and meet the measure of your responsibilities. A sense of self and a sense of perspective. Know yourself. Keep your priorities in order. Finally, and perhaps two of the most important, a sense of humor and a sense of discipline. This does not mean pie-in-your-face silliness, but rather the ability to discern among the various exigencies that will confront you. If you can sort out the truly important from the distracting commonplace, you have gained a head start on reducing pressures, enhancing enjoyment, and an ulcerless existence. And herein lies the self-discipline so badly wanting in our global society. Well, my allotted time has been exceeded by a long shot, and I can tell you that I can always tell my time has expired by watching President Clark. You know, I don't mind when he keeps looking at his watch, but it really gets distracting when he holds his watch to his ear and taps it to be sure it's still running. To sum up, then, my advice to you has been to come to your senses and lose more arrows. You may not long remember my jejune suggestions, but whatever you do reflect on today's milestone occasion, and is a major milestone for me too with my new honorary Bridgewater degree, please do try to keep in mind not only my admiration for your magnificent performance here at Bridgewater, but also my sincere hope that you will continue to navigate paths of excellence in your future endeavors. Congratulations, you carry our best wishes. Thank you.
Joanne, he did pretty well, don't you think?
I think so, too.
And Jack, if genius is perseverance, we're about to graduate quite a few geniuses in a moment. But I want to thank Jack for that great talk. It's now our pleasure to talk about an honorary degree. The granting of an honorary degree is a longstanding tradition of colleges and universities. Honorary degrees recognize those whose significant and sustained achievements make lasting contributions to society. Other than the earned doctorate, the honorary degree is the highest recognition that colleges and universities can bestow. I would now like to invite Mr. Durgan and Mr. Dr. Jack Sprager to join me next to the podium.
Dr. John Sprager, in recognition of your commitment to advancing the greater good through your support for public higher education, the Board of Trustees of Bridgewater State University is pleased to award and the President to confer the Doctorate of Public Education on honoris causa at this 2017 undergraduate commencement convocation with all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto. Congratulations, Dr. Sprager.
Very busy up here, very, very busy. I know it's getting warmer, and you're getting closer to that big moment. But we have one of your own who wants to say a few words. It's now my great pleasure to introduce our student speaker, Mr. Jacob Ames. That's a little louder than Kyle Bueno, and that's saying something, Jacob, you know? He's a physical education major. Jacob's held numerous leadership positions at his time here at Bridgewater. I personally have seen him everywhere. He was the recipient of the Bridgewater's Best Award as a brother of Sigma Pi, and has traveled with the university to Cambodia, where he aided in installing water filtration systems to provide clean drinking water to remote villages. Jacob, isn't that good? Jacob resides in Ashland, Massachusetts, and will be attending UMass Amherst in the fall to pursue a master's degree in higher education. Who knows, maybe he'll come back here for a job. Members of the class of 2017, please join me in welcoming, what happened? Okay, all right. He already cashed that check, didn't he? Okay. Please join me in welcoming your commencement speaker, Mr. Jacob Ames.
I apologize for how I sound. I tried to be sick for finals, but I was late to do that, so I thought this was the next best thing. I'd like to start off by saying congrats to the class of 2017. We are really good looking. Good morning. My name is Jacob Henry Ames, and it is my honor to be standing here as your commencement speaker today. Demonstrating gratitude is a theme I'm going to revisit, but first, I'd like to give thanks. Thank you, members of the Board of Trustees, President Fred Clark, what's up, dude? Bridgewater State University Administration, faculty, and staff for creating and fostering an environment where we as students are capable of achieving anything. Thank you to our families, friends, and support systems who helped our growth and made it possible for us to be here today. Thank you, Mom, Dad, Haley, Benny, Gwen, Brian, and Lucas for believing in me, even when I didn't believe in myself. Next, it is with great remorse that I ask us to remember students who passed away far too soon. Muad Abibi, Matthew Benting, James Crockett, Haley Sanford, Barry Patrick Brady, and James Keating. Let us not grieve, but instead celebrate their lives and their impact on all of us. They are and forever will be a part of our community and an integral piece of why so many of us call BSU home. I thank each of them for reminding us the true value of life, the importance of support, and the unmistakable power of love. The summer prior to my fifth year here at BSU, I traveled to the West Coast, looking to find myself on the hiking trail surrounding Mount Rainier in Washington State. 2 days for traveling and 2 days for exploring. Day one of hiking, I felt severely underwhelmed. To top it off, a poster on a bulletin board warning me about mountain lions and cougars served as a friendly greeting and a blunt reminder I was there alone. What my friends and family don't know is that I contemplated coming home early. I slept on it, tied my hiking boots a little tighter, packed a couple extra granola bars for the day, and decided to give it the old college try. As I stood on the precipice of what was my last chance to make something of this independent venture, I took a deep breath and marched forward. Surrounded by trees that stretched what looked like miles above my head, held a deep and vibrant green. As I felt the earth crunch beneath each step moving towards the summit, I honestly still have no idea what I was looking for. On my 4-hour journey up to Tolmie Peak, I had the pleasure of meeting an older couple who were finishing up their hike for the day. The path had narrowed to a part where a small bench stood as the logical resting point for hikers to take a moment and catch their breath. This is where I found the spunky 80-year-old duo preparing for their final trek back down the mountain. Their aura was warm and genuine. Frank and Holly were celebrating Frank's upcoming birthday, which, funny enough, is the same day as mine. Holly joked there was cake left up at the peak for me when I got there. The couple was holding hands, fondly remembering the family reunion they came from only a few days prior. Frank and Holly are from Oregon, but have done this Washington Trail many times before. I naively asked Frank and Holly if the view was worth it when I got to the top. Frank just smiled. He said, "The peak is great, but the best part about any hike is getting there. If you just go for the view at the top, then you miss everything else along the way." Before I had the chance to ask what was so great about the way up, Frank and Holly were on their feet and ready to move. They wished me luck with my upcoming semester and to enjoy the hike. They each gave me a hug and were on their way. As a great philosopher and iconic artist of our time has shared, ain't about how fast I get there, ain't about what's waiting on the other side, it's the climb. Miley Ray Cyrus is normally only good for wrecking ball references, but here she's right. There will be times you feel like you can't possibly keep climbing. You're tired. You're scared of the looming what-if questions you conjure up in your head, or you may just feel as though you've simply lost your way. Here's my message. Love your process. Be unequivocally devoted to your journey. I promise we all go through our fair share of both failures and successes, challenges and triumphs. The sum of our experiences and how we choose to respond is what ultimately defines our lives. Whether the peak you're trying to reach is something tangible like a bachelor's degree or a Super Bowl trophy, go Pats. Or maybe it's more personal, like your search for happiness, balance, or understanding. Be grateful for every moment that led to you getting here. Your past is behind you and your future is beyond worrying about. Be thankful for the here and now, this present moment. For BSU students, we may not be who we are today without hours spent in the RCC music rooms, a study tour abroad, or a Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 8 a.m. we just couldn't get out of taking. Whatever it may be thankful for that professor who stayed late for office hours. Be grateful for your experience to do service or learn in a country completely different than our own. Say thank you to your college best friend, especially if they woke up for most of those Monday, Wednesday, Friday classes, just to get ECC breakfast with you after. Gratitude allows us to be the best versions of ourselves. So many little moments have come to define our biggest accomplishments. Recognize and be thankful for all of it. I've been asked, Jake, what are you going to miss the most about BSU? My answer is always the people. But I can't imagine my time here without long talks on the steps of Boyden. summers spent with my fellow orientation leaders, working as an RA, or a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to do service in Cambodia. For all those moments and so many more, I'm grateful. Congratulations again to the class of 2017. Adventure awaits you. Continue climbing and let your moral compass be your guide. Cherish this journey and change the world. Thank you. Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you, Mr. Ames. We have now reached the point in the program that everyone has come to witness, the awarding of degrees. Would President Clark and Dr. Karim Ismaili, Interim Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs, please approach the podium.
Will the candidates for the bachelor degrees from the Lewis M. Ricciardi College of Business, the College of Education and Allied Studies, and the Bartlett College of Science and Mathematics please rise? President Clark, I am pleased to present Dr. Elmore Alexander, Dean of the Lewis M. Ricciardi College of Business, Dr. Lisa Battalino, Dean of the College of Education and Allied Studies, and Dr. Kristen Porter-Utley, Dean of the Bartlett College of Science and Mathematics.
President Clark, I am pleased to present the candidates in the Lewis M. Ricciardi College of Business for the degree of Bachelor of Science.
President Clark, I'm pleased to present the candidates in the College of Education and Allied Studies for the degree of Bachelor of Science and the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Education.
President Clark, I'm pleased to present the candidates in the Bartlett College of Science and Mathematics for the degree of Bachelor of Arts and the degree of Bachelor of Science.
Thank you. These are important words. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Bridgewater State University, I hereby confer the degrees of Bachelor of Arts and degrees of Bachelor of Science and welcome all of you to the company of educated and contributing citizens with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereto. Congratulations, and you could be seated.
Will the recipients of the bachelor's degrees in the Lewis M. Ricciardi College of Business please come forward?
The Lewis M. Ricciardi College of Business, major in accounting and finance, degree of Bachelor of Science, Jessica Nicole Alves, cum laude, Sergio Amato, David Biestis, Janet Brea Peguero, Aduzinda Cruz Brito, Eric Brown, Jonathan A. Burns, cum laude. Benjamin Chase. Louis Coche. Brittany Cullinane, cum laude. Yasmele de los Santos, magna cum laude. Alessandra Estrella. Eric Fallheffer, cum laude. Bridget L. Finnerty. Hunter John Fogarty, also majoring in management. Nicholas Vincent Forzano. Franklin E. Foto. John Frechette, magna cum laude, departmental honors in accounting and finance. Timur Shah Framoli. Samuel Becker Gardner, cum laude. Nicholas Gargano, magna cum laude. Justin Goff, cum laude. Nicholas Ryan Gunter, cum laude. Lei T. High, magna cum laude. Patrick James Harrington. Thomas Giovanni Hidalgo. Andrew McKinnon Higgins, cum laude. Paige Elizabeth Hill. Sushmita Islam, cum laude. Darnell C. Genet, summa cum laude. Elizabeth Ann Johnston. Devin Killian. Jenny Kuhn. Paige Lambert, cum laude. Megan Alyssa Larguino. Summa cum laude. Charles H. Lawson Jr., also majoring in management, summa cum laude. Kathy H. LaBeouf, magna cum laude. John M. Leone, cum laude. Deidre Maloney, cum laude. Danya Salim Marhamo, summa cum laude, departmental honors in accounting and finance. Daniel L. Mason. James Peter McNamee. Christy Marie Mello, cum laude. Jean Bruni Michaud, summa cum laude. Jennifer Colleen Merja, cum laude. Connor Murtaugh, also majoring in economics. Patrick Neal. Maxeline N. Nucha. Kayla Novasek. Andrea Andrade Nunez. Megan M. O'Kane, cum laude. John A. Pearson, also majoring in communication studies. Nelson Robles Jr., magna cum laude. Nicholas R. Rodriguez, summa cum laude. Colton M. Schilling, cum laude. Andre Teixeira Silveira. Jonathan Simcoe. Luis Leo Sodavia. Kristen Sullivan. Kelly Thompson, Natalie Torres, Patrick T. Walsh, Brittany Wesson, David Leroy Yarborough, cum laude, Jason Yatke Yu.
Major in Aviation Science, degree of Bachelor of Science, David Allard Jr. Charles Lewis Anderson, magna cum laude. Christopher Anthony Antunes, cum laude. Corey Michael Camara. Reed Thompson Chuda, magna cum laude. Michael Churchu, cum laude. Elenio F. Da Silva, cum laude. Alexandros Mikhail Davos. Bradley Aaron Dill, cum laude. Thomas W. Donlan. Andrew J. Dormady, cum laude. Jonathan Stephen Dziwanek. Jamie Engler. Edward Fitzgerald. Joseph Michael Gardner, cum laude. Christopher Alexander Jastrab. Carrie Lynn Cotman, magnum cum laude. Thomas Calvin Lemieux, cum laude. Tristan Francis McManus, summa cum laude. Brody William Moran, magna cum laude. Cody Murphy, magna cum laude. John Robert James Panetta. Sarah Eve Prendergast. Brody Storm Roderick. Nicholas Skaper. Josue Vladimir Tejada. Justin Vicent, summa cum laude. Paul Kervin S. Villapa. Brian L. Zayas Santiago.
Major in Management, degree of Bachelor of Science. Matthew Adams, cum laude. Derisu Alosa, magna cum laude. Jessica Alfama. Ramon S. Ambrosio. Emmanuel Korateng Amoko, magna cum laude. Cassandra Arujo, cum laude. Chelsea Arena, magna cum laude. Megan Elise Offenberg. Keegan Austin McGinnis. Anthony Alexis Aviles. Fronder Baez Romero. Alexis Marie Baffo. Anthony Barboza Vincente. Kayla Marie Barker, magna cum laude. Colleen Elizabeth Bartlett. Jacqueline Alexandria Beaucaire. Ashley Adora Bell, summa cum laude, Commonwealth Honors, Departmental Honors in Management. Stephen Bowers Moore. Taylor Brown. Tina Marie Brown, summa cum laude. Christopher Burton. Mario R. Cancel. Joseph N. Capello. Victor Cerami. Andrew David Chenard. Steve Chiem, summa cum laude. Mitchell Benjamin Tchaikovsky. Haley Marie Christian. Monique Churchill. Christina Cordero. Christina May Coleman. Magna cum laude. Amanda Ann Corellis. Brianna Marie Corsini, cum laude. Dennis M. Corvey II, also majoring in geography, departmental honors interdisciplinary. Maritonia R. Costa. Andrew R. Couture. Matthew Lewis Croker. Kevin Charles Crooker. James Thomas Crosby Jr., departmental honors in management. Cassandra Leanne Cushing. Stephanie Lorraine Da Silva. Joseph A. DiAgostino. James Thomas Dayhill. Tyler Donald DeCoster, magna cum laude. Darielle D. DeNito, cum laude. Courtney E. Dorcas. Colin Thomas Dowd, cum laude. Andrew James Doyle. Herlintz Edouard. Lyle Estefanos. Mark Damian Estramera. Leah Stacy Familaro, magna cum laude. Eric Daniel Fernandez. Taylor Fine. Rachel Christina Fiore, cum laude. Sarah R. Fistori. Allison Catherine Franey, summa cum laude. Eric Armin Garabedian, cum laude. Christopher Norman Garnett. Christian Luis Gesualdi. Anthony John Jabor Giancola, also majoring in physical education. Brandon Grant. Emily Ann Grant. Andrea Greason, cum laude. Allison N. Grundy. Carter Michael Guzzi, magna cum laude. Andrew J. Hall. Brian R. Hamill. Andrew Robert Harris, magna cum laude. Zachary Harris, cum laude. Catherine E. Hegel, cum laude. Stephen Joseph Hughes. Daniel V. Ivanoff, cum laude. Vanessa L. Jabajorian. Natasha May James. Nicole L. Johnson, cum laude. Wenson Joseph. James Michael Joyce, magna cum laude. Catherine Marie Kelleher, cum laude. Michael P. Kern. Rachel Kerens. Gianna Corey, cum laude. Chad Lawson. Danielle Crystal LaBeouf, also majoring in mathematics, magna cum laude. Jake LaCire. Peter Howard Leach, summa cum laude. Anthony David Licciardello. Ryan Jeffrey Lind. Alyssa Linkamper, cum laude. Jordan Brittany Livingston, cum laude. Ryan T. Loftus. Y. Yip Liu, magna cum laude. Kyle Thomas Lucier. Alexander Madison McCloskey. Connor Ford Maloney. Ryan R. Manning. Christopher Marcon. Holly Rachel McLean. Kayla Marie McEachran. Patrick Joseph McGinnis. Kendra M. McMasters. Erin Eileen Malore, magna cum laude. Paul Messina. Courtney K. Michael, cum laude. Evan Joseph Milo. Paul J. Miller. Alicia M. Montero. Angibel Moreta. Kevin Edward Morrissey. Keith James Murray. Ashley Nadeau. Andrew C. Nash. Nam T. Nguyen. Joseph Thomas Nichols. Ashley Nicole Obin.
Mark L. Pacheco, magna cum laude. Charlene S. Panner, cum laude. Sydney Brooks Passini. David C. Patton III. Scott Metz Perkin, cum laude. Brianna Petrisch. Courtney R. Pierce. Philip Pierre Louis. Delicia Pena, cum laude. Kyle Alexander Pynick. Alexandra Pohl. Mark Kevin Polson. Megan Porzio, cum laude. Kyle D. Provost, cum laude. Brandon Pulido. Thomas Paul Rafferty. Galen Marie Real, cum laude. Brendan Joseph Riley. Kayla Catherine Race. Kyle A. Rogers, magna cum laude. Miguel Dorserio Rodriguez. Andrea Rodriguez. Gabrielle Rodriguez. Gregory Romanco, cum laude. Michael E. Russo II. Andrew James Ross. Vincent Rotella. Matthew Robert Santos, cum laude. Alex Schlossberg, cum laude. Alexandra Havy Sassine. Elaine Sassine, magna cum laude. William Robert Sexton, cum laude. Brianna Carol Schaefer. Priscilla Miranda Silva. Christopher Simmons. Mohammed Musa Skaiki, cum laude. Timothy Joseph Smith. Victoria Rose Sousa. Shanti Sering. Alexis Nicole Taylor Stampley. Karina Faye Standring, cum laude. Daniel Francis Stanley. Jillian Marie Stone. Michelle Diane Sullivan. Robert E. Sullivan, Jr. Darwin Serpris. Evan James William Sylvia. Kayla Maria Shubarchik. Sui Tang. Taylor Michelle Tavares. Heather Ruth Taylor, cum laude. Javon Tracy Taylor. Brittany Joe Tedford Riley. Matthew John Tenori. Alexandra Todd. Susan Elizabeth Townsend. Emily Rose Tron. Zavaria Tropiano. Manuel David Vargas Jr. Joseph Edward Vitoles. Jeff Volmar.
Darian Watson. Patrick James Whalen, magna cum laude. Michelle Elizabeth Whipple, magna cum laude. Alexander Kennedy White. Nathaniel Scott White, cum laude. John Philip Whittemore. Joseph A. Williams. Brian Patrick Williamson. Hannah Alyssa Yanofsky, cum laude. Megan Rebecca Young. Claire Melissa Dalancourt. Rosina Amen Zama, cum laude. Joseph M. Zukas. Nelson Guan, also majoring in management and aviation science. Trisha Ayana Germain.
Will the recipients of the bachelor's degree in the College of Education and Allied Studies please come forward?
College of Education and Allied Studies. Major in Athletic Training. Degree of Bachelor of Science. Emily Marie Atkinson, cum laude. Justin J. Azoulay. Michael Issa Shamas. Cassandra Susan Chicolin, summa cum laude. Stephen Edmund Cook, cum laude. Alessandro Cubelli. Chelsea A. Eccleston, cum laude. Alexa Hambly. Vincent John DePaul Harpin, magna cum laude. Lisa Hebenstreet, cum laude. Matthew John Jones. Matthew Joyce. Amanda Page Leite, cum laude. Joseph Robert Murphy, cum laude. Nicole Norton. Donald J. Riley, Jr. Major in Communication Sciences and Disorders. Degree of Bachelor of Science. Taylor Louise Alphonse, cum laude. Allison Eliotto, magna cum laude. Kayla Marie Carrero, also majoring in English. Alyssa Mary Collins. Rochelle Dubois, cum laude. Amanda Diana Ellis. Jacqueline Marie Gadsby. Summa cum laude. Commonwealth Honors. Departmental Honors in Communication Sciences and Disorders. Madeline Giglio, magna cum laude. Stacy Marie Gleason. Hannah Rose Hallideth, magna cum laude. Danielle Hayes, cum laude. Catherine Taylor Jackson, cum laude. Caroline McKay Johnson. Jordan LeBlanc. Genesis Martinez Pietri. Molly Catherine Medeiros. Erin Michaela O'Leary, summa cum laude. Stephanie Pexoto, cum laude. Barbara Powers, magna cum laude. Danielle M. Premdas, magna cum laude. Krista Sansone. Courtney Karen Sheridan, magna cum laude. Jennifer Marie Skinner, summa cum laude. Allison Supple, cum laude. Christina Ann Sweeney. Gail A. Sweeney. Leah Sargent Thompson, magna cum laude. Sarah Elizabeth Tobias, cum laude. Lauren Jean Welch, cum laude, also majoring in psychology. Major in early childhood education. Degree of Bachelor of Science in Education. Brittany Roy Can. Jessica Ann Damaris. Nicole Angela Duclos. Sarah Mary Dufort. Stacy R. Gillard. Sarah R. Hendrickson. Taylor Alexis Nicola Cum Laude. Beth Elise Perlman. Ashley Marie Piaschi. Danielle Megan Terry. Kathleen M. Thomas, summa cum laude. Brittany Alice Tompkins, cum laude. Also majoring in art. Ciara Ariel Correro. Also majoring in English. Vanessa Ann Gehring, cum laude. Marissa Ann Perry, cum laude. Rayanne Christina Staude. Also majoring in history. Melissa Lynn Gonsalves, summa cum laude. Also majoring in mathematics. Kelsey Joanne Hardiman, cum laude. Samantha Ann McCracken. Also majoring in psychology. Alexis Nicole Alvey, cum laude. Lauren Marie Burgess, magna cum laude. Sarah E. Cornell, cum laude. Megan Christine Fitzgerald, magna cum laude. Kelsey Rose Kiley. Kristen Marie Kaczynski, cum laude. Megan J. Liel, cum laude. Abigail Noel Lapata, magna cum laude. Linda Marie Mercado. Josephine Alice Mountain, magna cum laude. Sydney Elizabeth Peolela, summa cum laude. Cassandra Ann Riley, cum laude. Michaela Marie Terrell, summa cum laude. Major in elementary education. Degree of Bachelor of Science in Education. Also majoring in art, Alexandra Rose Cast, magna cum laude. Jessica Casares, magna cum laude. Michaela Ann Smith, magna cum laude. Also majoring in biology, Caitlin Comer, summa cum laude, Commonwealth Honors, Departmental Honors in Elementary Education. Emily McDonald. Sarah Catherine Seltzer. also majoring in communication studies. Samantha Morgan Enos, magna cum laude. Melissa Jean Moore, cum laude. Also majoring in earth sciences. Sarah Ann Drinkwater. Also majoring in economics. Rachel Mamel, summa cum laude. Also majoring in English, Megan Marie Allen. Taylor Christine Almeida, cum laude. Megan Elizabeth Amaral, magna cum laude. Alexandra Lee Anderson. Melinda Sue Bossi, summa cum laude. Kendall Lauren Chandler, summa cum laude. Ashley Elizabeth Chesworth. Teresa Conley, magna cum laude. Tiana Rose Cook, magna cum laude. Devin DeMartino, cum laude. Raven Elizabeth Farrell, magna cum laude. Kayla Nicole Flaherty, cum laude. Kayla Marie Giovino, cum laude. Melissa Y. Ma, summa cum laude. Claire Mahady Carter, summa cum laude. Carly Ann Massey, cum laude. Kelly Marie McCarthy, cum laude. Bridget McCarthy Houlihan. Bridget Nee, magna cum laude. Alyssa E. Pimentel, magna cum laude. Ashley Lauren Roscoe, cum laude. Mariah Elizabeth Scott, magna cum laude. Catherine Ray Sebastio, summa cum laude.
Also majoring in geography. Michaela Alexandra Bethune, summa cum laude. Emily Holstein, magna cum laude. Ashley Elizabeth Nina Lawrence, cum laude. Robert Lawrence, magna cum laude. Olivia M. Perry, magna cum laude. Also majoring in history, Amanda Bernenberg. Lindsay Cohoon, cum laude. Allison Jean Kukali, summa cum laude. Carolyn M. Cullen, magna cum laude. Jillian Kathleen Gardner, cum laude. Sheila Claire Hallgren, cum laude. Abigail Marie Pustis, summa cum laude. Savannah Elizabeth Tayo. Kayla Jean Wesson, magna cum laude. Also majoring in mathematics, Cassandra Michaela DeRozano, cum laude. Amanda Rose Furtado, summa cum laude. Kimberly Hallahan, magna cum laude. Tori Lee Johnson, cum laude. Alicia Lindy. Lynn Lee, cum laude. Brittany Elizabeth Solomon, cum laude. Kelly Young, summa cum laude. Also majoring in philosophy, Edith DaCosta. Also majoring in psychology, Kayla Patricia Agan, magna cum laude. Madison Danielle Doherty. Melissa Catherine Doherty. Sarah E. Demick, summa cum laude. Samantha Marie Favreau, cum laude. Bridget Figueroa, magna cum laude. Elizabeth Louise Hayes, cum laude. Brittany Elizabeth Kiesmore. Kelly Elizabeth Lewis Hicks, cum laude. Danielle P. Sanchez. Amina Sedarevic, cum laude. Samantha Murphy Sullivan, magna cum laude. Also majoring in sociology, Nicole Marie Aldrichs, cum laude, departmental honors in sociology. Lauren Elizabeth Gagnon. Amanda Keenan, summa cum laude. Also majoring in Spanish, Kristen Denise Arnold, summa cum laude, Commonwealth honors, departmental honors, interdisciplinary. Shella Cabral Carrero, cum laude. Shannon Douglas Seuss, magna cum laude. Major in Health Studies, degree of Bachelor of Science. Caitlin Emily Abbott, cum laude. Nicole Leah Abbott, cum laude. Nicole Alexandra Almeida. Brianna Margaret Acaro. Lauren Patrice Berenger, magna cum laude. Rebecca Bonifant. Jenna Lynn Cohen, magna cum laude. John Joseph Collins V. Jomali Talia Colon. Rebecca Ann Conley. Erica Morgan Corey, summa cum laude. Carla DeRosa. Salamawit Kasagani Debosh. Carlene Olivier Decimus. Joanna Delaney, summa cum laude. Kayla L. Dabina, cum laude. Marissa Rorick Dole, magna cum laude. Jessica Marie Erasmi. Winnie Gomes. Nicole Beth Goodrow. Monique Tiana Sherry Granum. Cameron Stiles Grindier. Stephanie Marie Guerriero. Jesse P. Guy. Martha and Jerry Ikua. Brianna Genti. Olivia Rose Johnson, magna cum laude. Takesha Amy Joseph. Ariel Lessef, cum laude. Kayla Mae McGurin.
Luke Francis McLernan, magna cum laude. Stanley Ann Ashley Michaud, cum laude. Dolores Monamu. Ashley Payne, cum laude. Mary Edna Quigg, cum laude. Galvier Romero. Michaela Elizabeth Ross. Kelsey A. Rook. Kara McKenzie Sylvia, cum laude. Leah Grace Tinkham, summa cum laude, departmental honors in health studies. Kelsey Elizabeth Vanconcelos. Stephanie Lee Vitauskas, cum laude. Kristen Elise White, magna cum laude. Tantiana T. Williams.
Major in physical education. Degree of Bachelor of Arts. Miguel Alicea. Hector Giuliano Amaro. Katja S. Andrada. Anthony James Bullo. Sean Aaron Kamire. Scott M. Casasa Jr. Matthew Hallaby. Kerson Joseph. Andrew Francis Keown, cum laude. Emily Stearns Langua. Lindsay Mansfield. Sarah McNiff. Corey L. Nota. Alex O'Reilly. Juan J. Perez. Tracy Marie Perry, cum laude. Francis Devon Phillips, cum laude. Christopher Peter Pilkington. Travis Ritchie. Timothy Paul Sheehan. Scott Sodre. Tori Vargas, magna cum laude. Sarah Marie Ayala Wazlowski. Ryan White. Brian Yoon. Degree of Bachelor of Science. Charnel Dana Anderson. Jamie S. Barnes. Diana Marie Barry. Sydney Bennett, cum laude. Ryan Berrialt. Amanda Boudreau. Emily Claire Bray, magna cum laude. Sophia R. Bruno. Melissa Lynn Butler. Cameron Jordan Cabaceras, magna cum laude. Amanda Coet, cum laude. Hannah Caponi, cum laude. Amber Lynn Carpenter. Tyler David Champagne, cum laude. Angela Marie Clement. Evan Michael Conley, cum laude. Kimberly Contreras. Alexander Cordon. Anthony Cote. Elise Ariel Coughlin. Morgan Cox. Jennifer Ann Crane, cum laude. Jacob D'Alessandro. Evan James Dean. Tyler DeMello, cum laude. Patrick Dempsey. Stephanie Elizabeth DeSantis, cum laude. Megan Grace Dupuy, magna cum laude. Kevin A. Echeverry. Casey Enderlin. Ryan Feeney. Joseph Alain Francois Jr. Jordan Ronald Frazier. Haley Grimes, magna cum laude. Guilherme Santos Guerrera, magna cum laude. Lamia M. Hamey, cum laude. Daria Alexandrova Hamilton, cum laude. Emily Ann Herrick, magna cum laude. Kayla Johnson Robinson. Ashley Kelly. Joshua David Kilmonas, summa cum laude. Ariana Lefebvre, summa cum laude. Janine Langley. Courtney Marie Letty, magna cum laude. Amanda Lynn Libetruth. Alexandra Lynch. Connor E. McLeod. Christopher Daniel Maratta. Hannah Rose Maimon, magna cum laude. Samantha Lee McChesney, cum laude. Erin Patricia McGovern. Louise L. McHale. Megan Ashley Medeiros. Jamie Lee Mello, cum laude. Rafaela Mendes. Corey Tyler Miranda. Brian A. Monroy. Patrick Ian O'Connell, magna cum laude. Charles James O'Connor. Sheila J. O'Sullivan, summa cum laude. Spencer Matthew Perlmutter, cum laude. Justin Keith Pierce. Jonathan Perez, cum laude. Jonathan Richard, magna cum laude. Shelby Elizabeth Roberts, cum laude. Elizabeth May Ross, cum laude. Thomas B. Rutledge. Matthew Santos, cum laude. Richard P. Shea. Tony Alexandra Sneed, cum laude. Michael Simon Marins Soros. Kevin Sosa Ospina. Michael Dean Spiri. Andrew Joseph Vernalia. Kenny Virtus, cum laude. Maggie Vieira, magna cum laude. Michael Vuono. Joshua Benjamin Ward. Jacob Dylan Weber. Kelly White, magna cum laude. Beverly Marie Woods, cum laude.
Major in Special Education. The degree of Bachelor of Science in Education. Jennifer Gallagher. Ariel Shaniqua McManus. Alyssa Deborah Perry. Ashley Rose Rifa, magna cum laude. Samantha Carol Westgate. Also majoring in Communication Studies, Kelsey Kilduff, magna cum laude. Also majoring in English, Elizabeth Patricia Jensen, summa cum laude. Ashley Ribello, magna cum laude. Also majoring in psychology, Charlotte Rose Kerwin, summa cum laude. Hannah Lee Lawson. Elizabeth Cheryl Levesque, summa cum laude. Sarah Elizabeth Long, magna cum laude. Sarah Nicole Lussiere, summa cum laude. Tori Lynn McIntyre, cum laude. Morgan Meredith Rowe, cum laude. Nicole Marie Scow, magna cum laude. Samantha Sherman, summa cum laude. Carolyn Amanda Truax, cum laude. Elizabeth Whitney, cum laude. Fallon C. Hiltz, magna cum laude.
Will the recipients of the bachelor's degrees in the Bartlett College of Science and Mathematics please come forward?
Bartlett College of Science and Mathematics. Major in Biology. Degree of Bachelor of Arts. Arthur Haylander Alvis. Shanice M. Andre. Deborah Ashabor. Amanda M. Auger. Melissa L. C.A. Kara J. Gorman. Tanya R. Greenwood. Chris Laguerre. Elizabeth Ann Mantalos, magna cum laude. Leanna Montgomery, cum laude. Sean M. O'Brien, cum laude. Kayla O'Grady, cum laude. Emily A. Ryan. Jessica Joanne Santos, cum laude. Degree of Bachelor of Science. Katie Lynn Almeida. Also majoring in elementary education, magna cum laude. Nicole Lynn Aruda. Summa cum laude, Commonwealth Honors, Departmental Honors in Biology. Nemdi Obawani Azbuko, cum laude. Kathleen Alyssa Bailey, summa cum laude. Aliana L. Bercier. Eric Apong Boteng. Michaela Brady, summa cum laude. Jennifer Bree Brunel. Nicole Bridget Carroll. Dimitri Claude. Michaela Alexandra Cote, Departmental Honors in Biology. Sabine Robin Etienne, magna cum laude. Shantae Fernandez, summa cum laude. Melanie D. Fernandez. Alexa Marie Ferreira. Rachel Renee Gelino, magna cum laude, Commonwealth Honors, Departmental Honors in Biology. Mary Gill. Stephen Gerard Jr. Sarah M. Hagopian. Allison Hargis, cum laude. Brandon Joseph Hoyle, also majoring in physical education, cum laude. Michelle Jeanette, cum laude, Commonwealth Honors, Departmental Honors in Biology. Colin John Jepson, cum laude. Ryan William Jones. Sarah May Jones. Megan Ann Joyal, summa cum laude. Nathaniel E. Cage. Colleen Elizabeth Kemsky. Jordan April Kinnear, cum laude. James Warren Kotlowski, summa cum laude. Katerina Eleni Lampros, cum laude. Maria Eugenia Lopes. Danielle J. Lopez, magna cum laude. Nicole Luz. Casey Rose McElhaney. Andrew McGinnis, also majoring in history, summa cum laude, Commonwealth honors, departmental honors in history. Sarah McMahon. Michaela Audrey McPherson. Ryan Miller. Grace P. Mulvey. Samantha Ashley Niles. Krishna Parikh, also majoring in criminal justice. Sydney Sherry Quirk, magna cum laude. Blake Taylor Rennie, magna cum laude. Jocelyn L. Salvador. Samantha Jean Sawyer, departmental honors in biology. Basima Shams. Caitlin Christina Shaw, cum laude. Fatina Scala, magna cum laude. Quentin D. Silvera. Andrew Charles Single. Ashley E. Smith, magna cum laude, Commonwealth honors, departmental honors in biology. Madison Lorraine Smith. Abigail Jean Sylvia, cum laude. Anthony Tedeschi. Tyler A. Tedesco, summa cum laude. Leani Brito Teixeira. Jacqueline Rose Toomey, cum laude. Patricia Rebecca Vequitini, magna cum laude. Danielle Louise Webster. Shay Elizabeth Wygand. Jacqueline A. Welch, cum laude. Jocelyn Marie Westgate.
Major in Chemistry, degree of Bachelor of Science, Richard Benjamin Aruz. Ryan J. Cabral. Delmayo Delmira Brandao Correa. Michael Thomas Cryan. Kathleen E. Dooley. Nathan Mitchell Evanowski, magna cum laude. Phoebe Curris, summa cum laude. Megan Rose Norton. Jessica Rose Raymond, cum laude. Kayla Ruggiero, also majoring in psychology. Candace Jean Sheehan, cum laude. Matthew Tuffy. Malia Tupé. Major in Computer Science, degree of Bachelor of Science. Edson Patrick Rodriguez Andrade. Patrick Edward Braunice. Craig Reginald Bush, cum laude. Jose Caraballo. Ernest C. Dowplays. Connor Fitzgerald. Krista Gazzola, cum laude. Edward Hall, cum laude. Daniel Housley, summa cum laude. Wilbertini Jean Marie. Luke McDonald, cum laude. James L. Murray II, cum laude. Michael John Pina. Cassandra Pizarro, summa cum laude. Jeffrey Turner. Kayla Rose Velez. Major in Earth Science, the degree of Bachelor of Science. Autumn Alexis Burrell, cum laude. Commonwealth Honors, Departmental Honors in Geological Sciences. Jenny Lee Marie Canucci. Marissa Gepner. Krista L. Greeley. Justin Severin Snook, summa cum laude. Mark Stephen Waller. Major in Environmental Geoscience, degree of Bachelor of Science. Nathan Charles White, cum laude. Major in Geography, degree of Bachelor of Arts. Joseph Mario Ferrazzi. The degree of Bachelor of Science, Stephen P. Brennan. Brittany Danielle Dubois. Christopher J. Feroli, Jr. Cameron Francis Frazier. Michelle Carol Eleni Frizel. Philip M. Grant. Ninoshka Juanz Herrera, magna cum laude. Luis J. Lopez. Eva Marguerite Ratcliffe, summa cum laude. Andrew Roberts, cum laude. Paul J. Salinas. Tiffany Maya Thomas. The major in Geological Sciences, degree of Bachelor of Science, Ryan Patrick Brown. Major in Mathematics, degree of Bachelor of Science, John Ballerino, also majoring in English. Alexis Renee Berry, cum laude. Samantha Blazier, cum laude. Tamika K. Braun. Emily M. Cannata. Michael D. Delisle. Kelsey Dillon, summa cum laude. Olivia Rose Gagnon. Scott Allen Gardner, cum laude. Drew Guay. Tony Huang. Allison Elizabeth Johnson, cum laude. Melissa M. Kaur. Miranda Kowalski, summa cum laude. Lauren J. Kristopolsky. Jillian E. LaCapelle. Kang Y. Yan Min.
Troy J. Pappas, also majoring in economics. Marjorie Partridge, magna cum laude. Zachary Ricciardi. Sabrina Lynn Rizzo, summa cum laude. Jeffrey Stephen Roberts. Brian Sheehan, magna cum laude. Commonwealth Honors, Departmental Honors in Mathematics. Simon Sullivan, Departmental Honors in Mathematics. Tori Sullivan. Sean Francis Turk. Vincent Vesimini, magna cum laude, Departmental Honors in Mathematics. Samantha P. Vieira. Michael T. Viola. Victoria Nadine Walter. Mark Stephen Waring Jr. Brendan T. Walsh. Tashani Lejean Williams Kaur. Major in Physics, degree of Bachelor of Science. Nicholas Bryden, summa cum laude, Departmental Honors in Physics. Amanda Lee Coughlin, summa cum laude. Brandon Dodelin, cum laude, Departmental Honors in Physics. David Jeffrey Olofsson, also majoring in Chemistry, summa cum laude, Departmental Honors in Physics. Casey Richard Hartigan, cum laude. Kevin Roebuck, also majoring in Chemistry, summa cum laude, Commonwealth Honors, Departmental Honors in Physics. Our student speaker from the College of Education and Allied Studies, a degree of Bachelor of Science in Education, major in Physical Education, Jacob Henry Ames. Our class marshal from the Bartlett College of Science and Mathematics, degree of Bachelor of Science, major in Management, Clara Maiz Gonzalez, summa cum laude. Class marshal from the Bartlett College of Science and Mathematics, degree of Bachelor of Science, major in Mathematics, Cameron Andrew Ramos, summa cum laude.
Okay, my friends, by the way, my hand hurts, but for a good reason. We want to welcome all of you with open arms, all of our graduates, to the community of scholars and professionals, and guess what? Your tassels can now be changed. Well done, Bears. It is now my pleasure to ask Dr. Michael Vieira of the Bridgewater State University Alumni Association and graduate of the class of 1975 to come to the podium and officially induct our graduates
and to the Alumni Association of Bridgewater State University. Dr. Vieira.
To be a witness to this induction, I call upon all alumni of Bridgewater State University who are present to please stand up.
That's you.
He stole my line. President Clark, upon your recommendation, I am pleased to induct into membership in the Alumni Association the graduates of the class of 2017 at Bridgewater State University. Fellow alumni, I welcome you into the association with all of us who have preceded you and ask that you share a continued interest in the welfare and excellence of Bridgewater State University. I offer each of you my warm congratulations and best wishes. You can please be seated.
Thank you, Dr. Vieira. Sorry, I have to make you please rise one more time. I would now like to invite Father Bill Devine to the podium to offer the benediction.
Let's thank God for a lot of answered prayers. Let's bow our heads and pray. Lord, while this graduation ceremony comes to an end, it marks a new beginning for these graduates. I ask you, Lord, to bless these graduates not only with faith that enables them to believe in you, but the humility to always ask your help. Bless them with the desire to live up to the motto of this university, to minister unto others. Bless those who are still uncertain about their careers. Give them patience and the direction they need. Bless these graduates with success in finding jobs that will enable them to help them pay off their student loans. And as they celebrate their graduation with their family and friends tonight and the days ahead, bless them with good judgment and keep them safe. Amen.
Thank you, Father Devine. At this time, I ask Ms. Maloney to come forward and lead us in singing the first verse of the Alma Mater. The words are on the back of the program. Thank you, Ms. Maloney. Please be seated. Thank thank you for celebrating the accomplishments of our graduates. You may rejoin our graduates at the reception in the Campus Center courtyard immediately following the ceremony. Please remain in your seat until the reception has filed out of the tent. We appreciate your cooperation in exiting the tent after the recessional so that we may prepare for our afternoon commencement. Congratulations, class of 2017.